ordered a taxi and been left standing on the curb, guys?
Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah, well, many people are voting with their feet and jumping into an Uber X, a ride-sharing service that's putting the taxi industry in a lot of hot water. And there's one man who's making it his mission to stop it in his tracks. He's a former British police officer, hire car owner, and now it seems a wannabe vigilante. Russell Howarth is booking ride shares through Uber, then performing citizens' arrests on drivers when they show up.
I am arresting you. I'm placing you under citizens' arrest. That is because what you're doing is illegal.
Because I'm an albatross.
After nearly 10 arrests, he's threatening more. But what's his problem? Technically, UberX is illegal, but the company says the law is outdated and is paying the fines dished out to their drivers. Please welcome Russell. Hi, Russell. Can you explain this? Because is there a difference between Uber and UberX?
Absolutely there is. So Uber, fantastic concept, great technology, completely legal. Pushing the boundaries, but legal.
And this is the online ordering system for taxis, existing taxi cabs.
Well, initially it was hire cars, then they went into taxis because they wanted to make more money. Mm-hmm. And now they've thought, well, how can we make even more money? And they've gone into private cars. And actually what you just said on the grab there was that Uber will pay the fines. There's the first little warning sound, pay the fines. They don't pay the legal costs and they don't tell the people that face the fines that they might get fined.
So what though, Russell, is your concern? Because a lot of people say Uber's fantastic, it's reliable, I know it'll be safe. But then with UberX, what is the issue? Because you're actually a hire car driver, aren't
Correct,
you?
Correct, yes. Mm. So basically, when you get into a public transport vehicle, you have an expectation that the vehicle will be adequately insured, for instance. Mm-hmm. So imagine you get into a car and you have an accident and you find out that it's not insured because it was insured for personal use and all of a sudden the green slip's invalidated. Mm-hmm. You know, they had a terrible tragedy in the US. You know, it could have been any vehicle, but as it happened, it was an UberX car and it hit a little girl on a pedestrian crossing. The girl died. Uber actually washed their hands completely of it.
So the Uber's difference not liable.
Uber's not liable for anything that happens in the car, wouldn't they?
Well, that's what they say. They say they're not liable. But the disturbing thing for me is that because they tell the drivers that it's actually legal, and this is the bad thing, they don't come clean and say, look, it is illegal, but run the gauntlet. They say it's legal, so they lie to them. So this poor gentleman who, you know, it was a horrific, unfortunate incident, but he thought he was insured. He then tried to claim on his insurance, and his insurance said, well, hang on a second, you're driving kind of like a quasi-taxi. You know, you told us it was a private insurance policy, so they're not paying out. Now the man is, you know, he's up, he's got all this publicity, he's up in court, it just, you know, destroying his life.
We and can't that's really, what Uber we does. Can't really verify that, can we? But tell me, so the difference is a professional driver, a hire car driver,
professional.
They're in a car that is insured to take people hither and yon, and the driver has certain obligations. So a Uber X is just anybody in anybody's car. Is that the difference?
That's right. So basically, I mean, you know, anyone over the age of 21, you can do an online training session and download the app, and Uber will hook you up, I think the term is they're using at the moment, and you can be out there driving in a couple of hours and picking up people. It's almost like hitchhiking with a stranger. And the problem is the public don't know if these people have had the relevant probity checks. Because obviously when you go to be a taxi or a limo driver, you have to perform a certain number of government checks.
Isn't the real problem, Russell, that the taxi industry has been sick for a long time, you call a taxi, it doesn't show up. It's the only service provider that you actually has no obligation to provide a service. I've nearly missed this show because a taxi I booked the night before simply didn't show up. And when I rang up to say where it was, I said, oh, well, we just didn't send one. It's just not there. You know, when you're out at night after on a Friday or Saturday night in any major city in Australia, there is a massive shortage of taxis and it can lead to fights in taxi ranks. It can lead to you not getting home for hours and hours and hours. And of course, there's a vested interest in the taxi industry wanting to maintain that shortage because that way they can charge more money and they're more in demand. People are crying out for Uber, aren't they?
Interesting point. Look, I agree with everything you've just said. The only problem is, you know when you said when there's that, they want to keep that demand. Do you know what Uber actually does when the demand soars? They surge the price. I personally had someone in my car, had to pay $973 because the supply and demand had skewed. So you might get a nasty shock if you get into an Uber when there's absolutely no cars. But technology is the way forward. I think that the Uber have brought a fantastic concept. It's just a shame that they break the law. And ultimately, Uber wipes their hands of anything. So why... I mean, these uni kids they're targeting now, you know, using mum and dad's car. Just imagine if they want to practice law or something and then they end up getting charged and it ruins their life. They can't go into their chosen profession because Uber hasn't told them what they're doing is illegal. So everything you say is valid, but it's, you know, is breaking the law the answer? I don't think it is.
Russell, and we asked Uber to actually make a comment and to come on the show today and we haven't heard back from them. So
yeah, well,
thank you
for
joining us.
They're not too keen to actually... But in terms of what I do in the arresting, I've actually offered to every single UberX driver that I've encountered, I'd offer to help them through the process, get them a legal licence and even set them up in a brand new car because Uber's actually paying these people a lot less than they would be making if they were actually a legitimate driver. So I feel sorry. These people are being exploited. It's not about the drivers. It's fairly and squarely about Uber. Now just do the right thing.
The industry needs to lift its game, the taxi industry.
Absolutely.
Russell,
absolutely.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much,
guys. No, OK. He's got to go and get a cab. Still to come, Ange Bishop will join us live from London. Before we go, just a slight correction regarding our interview on Uber. Uber did respond to our calls but decided not to take part in our segment today.